All right, ladies and germs, time for a little whimsy. 65th anniversary of Godzilla and Round 2's going in with a full deck of cards. We've got the MPC Army Jeep, as it would be seen in Invasion of the Astro-Monster in 125th scale. It's got the Jeep, the Cannon, and Gojira! So let's take a look at everything that's going to be in the box when you get yours. This kit has been issued a good number of times. What you should know that in this box are also the parts to build the Suri. So if you want to do a Three's Company diorama where they're going to the zoo, you have the parts for that as well. First up here, all molded in green, the entire kit except for some chrome parts. We've got the glass, we've got that nice dashboard, we've got the basic seats. This is an Army Jeep, so it's not going to be all decked out. Should be a nice fun build, but it's got a lot of details for being an older, smaller size kit. You can see the shocks, the four cylinder, the fuel, everything on there, the drivetrain. Really a lot of detail on this little guy, even that nice fine little steering wheel. I'm not noticing any flash that needs to be a concern. Even the grill is molded open. We've got that nice hood with the latches still crisp on it. So somebody at Round 2's been taking care of these molds here. We've got the other grill option. We've got some fuel tanks. We'll flip this tree over. We've got a fuel tank. We've got some tools. We've got lights. We've got what looks like some mounts for the machine guns. We've got some handheld machine guns. We got a 50 cal there. On this tree, we've got a stretcher. We've got what looks like a radio with its little antenna. They have to report back where we see a Godzilla. Check that out. All right, we got those parts there. We got the chassis and the frame as two parts. I pushed them together just so you can see after all these years how nice that frame still fits on that body. But that's a separate piece to detail and paint. And then we've got the body there of the Jeep. We've got the large cannon here that sits off the front to shoot at Godzilla, and the top of the Suri. If you're wondering what the Suri looks like, it is on the box. With all the cool box art. There we go. Suri option, Army Jeep option. So you can still build both when you get this kit. Now on the other side of the table, we've got a nice chrome tree. Nothing on mine's going to be chrome. But if you want to do a custom Jeep, you've got all this option there. I will just be attaching the parts and painting over them in olive drab. We've got a real nice set, a full five set of the Goodyear Permacord tires. They are branded and they look very nice. We'll put those on there. They'll look the part. We've got two sets of decals. We've got the planetary defense option, which is what I'll be doing, and the U.S. Army option, which you can do on your own with a lot of white decals in there and significations. Also, the piece de resistance in this kit is a diorama sheet, and it's huge. So we're going to have to go about it in sections before I'm all done. Then we'll get to see it all put together. But on one, we've got part of a backdrop, we've got utility poles, we've got our instructions, we've got a massive Gojira. Yes, there goes Tokyo, here comes Godzilla. So he's going to be awesome on there. And then the other sheet sitting on the table in front of us is the backdrop of what I can only assume is Mount Fuji, with some more power poles so we get a little foreground detail of one in front with Godzilla behind them. And a little foreground action, so we'll be putting all those together. So, all right, I'm going to go degrease my parts with some simple green, and then we will be back for a sub-assembly show-off. Yeah, we're getting ready to take on Gojira and fight him with the Willis MB Jeep from Invasion of the Astro Monster through MPC. The assembly is real nice. Now, I want to show you something. In the manual, it says that do not use the tailgate and the spare tire and the jerry can if you're going to use the recoilless rifle. Well, I'm going to use the recoilless rifle, and there's the mount for it in the box. And there's the tailgate. I assembled everything, and it fits just fine. Even with it angled up a little bit, we're going to have plenty of room for it with the tailgate there. And with anything I put on the tailgate, we're still going to have plenty of swing room. Now, I'm going to be gluing this into place once we're all done. I'm going to be painting the mount for the cannon with the body and the whole thing olive drab, same with the frame and everything else. That's going to be painted. The rifle is going to be painted black and then lightly brushed with gunmetal to simulate that it's a metal rifle. But, you know, I want it to look like the box, just like that. We're not building a perfect military replica here. I want it to look like the box. I want it to look like the movies. That's my gist of this. And this is a very nice kit of a Jeep, too, by the way. If you wanted to build a Early's Willis MB Jeep, you're going to be awesome with it. So feel free to attach that tailgate and test fit your wheel and spare tire and everything. And those are accessories I definitely want to put on here. So you can see that we've got that mount in there. We've got the shifters. We've got the steering column, the dashboard, the pedals. We've got the radiator. You can all mount this in advance. I did. There's a pre-drilled hole in the bottom of the fender. I did push it all the way through and mount the night light, the blackout light. We got those beautiful handles all the way around glued in. We've got our lights on each side. So it looks just like the box. Like I said, I'm doing it up just like the box, whether it's military correct or not. When I paint the, where'd they go? When I paint the shovels and the axles will be mounted just below the driver's side area. But there's our sweet jerry can and mount. Make sure you use this grill. Make sure you use the right grill number with the small headlights and multiple bars. You don't want to try to put on this grill. That's for the Surrey. So if you're building the Surrey, use the one with the big headlights, the updated grill. The military one, of course, is going to have the smaller grill, the original style grill. I have also assembled the shells for the recoilless cannon and the radio and the antenna. I'm going to be using them all, definitely in this kit with the details. We've got the hood ready to paint. We've got the fan, generator, and belts. Those I'm going to do in black just for a little contrast. Same with the battery. We've got the frame assembled. You can see how nice that goes together. Beautiful. They've even got front steering mechanism on there. What I did now was glued on the front bumper and the front license plate holder so I can put those planetary defense decals on it and on the bumper, and I want those to be the same color as the frame, so I've glued those all on with super glue. Now we've test fitted the chassis a couple times just to make sure it keeps fitting, and I can assure you that the pins line up. There's no twist, there's no issues. You can see how far out it sticks for those nice emblems, and we'll be able to get all that together. So all of it's gone together very nice. We've got that little four banger with its transfer case. If you're having questions, the manual isn't that clear about the transfer case. Take a look at it, how it mounts off the side with the big ring in the back and the little ring in the front so that you know where to mount your drive shafts. We've got the intake and the exhaust. We've got the distributor all on there. Some of the chrome parts, this is all get painted olive drab. I'm going to try to find some contrasting colors of green, even though in the real Jeep, they would have been more of a blended together for the exact reason of camouflage. I'm going to try doing the frame in a darker color of drab and the body in a lighter color, the wheels in a sub-color, just so we get a little bit of contrast and stuff on there. We've got all five wheels together, front, rear, and spare. We got our steering wheel ready to go. We've got our exhaust, which will be pretty much the only metallic part on the entire kit. That'll get painted up. So I'm just going to head over to paint. I'm going to throw black primer on everything first. Then we'll go in and start putting our color coats, so come along. out of the paint booth. Everything is dry, so I'm ready to start doing final painting and final assembly. Now, I've got the glass brushed with Future. That's the only part that's going to be using Future on here. Obviously, we're not going to be gloss coating anything else. So I've got that on there. That will dry. I just need to put in the windshield and the smaller headlights. The larger headlights are used for the Surrey version. That'll take an hour or two to dry, and then I can start working with it. The seats, the cushions themselves will get hand-painted a tan or a tan-brown color because I want to have a little bit of contrast on the Jeep. You can see that the recoilless rifle is sitting on its mount. That just pulls off. That looks nice in its Canyon Black. I will be dry brushing that with some gunmetal craft paint. Our exhaust is ready to go. That'll just be simply bolted in. Our radio and antenna were painted in a contrasting color to the olive drab so that they do stand out when I do attach them. And I have to just paint some teeny little details on the radio in black and then maybe give that a wash. We've got our battery and our belt system done up in black. We're not going for World War II accurate. We're going for B-movie looking. We've got the drive shafts done. We've got the body done in that beautiful olive drab. Everything from the gun mount to the tanks to the shifters, which I'll paint the knobs black. The steering column, everything is olive drab. The frame itself is that dark green. Now, there is a contrast, and I do like it a lot. The differences in those colors. I like the standout of a little bit of a frame coming out. You can see a little better around the back where we've got those bumpers. I do like the difference in the two. That's just my choice. I'm going to pretend that the B-movie had to buy a bunch of these surplus Jeeps and cobble a couple together to film the movies. So some had darker tones after being repainted. Some had lighter. It's my build. Same with the engine and transfer case that I painted up. I'll pick out a couple details there in black, and otherwise that's going right underneath. You're not going to see much of that, of course. The windshield is fully operational. That will be able to snap in and tilt forward and back as much as we want it to. Obviously, they're going to have it tilted forward when they're firing the rifle, or it would blow the glass right out of the windows. We've got our entrenching tools right there. We're going to be painting those up in full color wood with metal blades, their straps, and then gluing that to the body. We've got our grill ready to go. I have to take a little piece of styrene. I'm just going to cut it out and glue it to the front of the grill after I put the grill on so I can put our planetary defense emblem on there like it would be in the movie. The wheels and tires are all set. Those don't need anything at all. Maybe a little black wash inside, if anything. But the black undertone really brought out those colors on top and let them stay dark underneath. So probably don't even need it on those. Nor do I with the spare. The steering wheel just needs its black plastic ring painted in, but the center of it will stay the olive drab green, similar to the real thing. So there's very little work to be done. I do have to paint the dashboard. Those tiny little gauges up in front there will be a black. I'm not sure if I'll use paint or pen for that. It doesn't matter. And then just a little scrub with a silver pencil. And then we'll black out these little knobs and buttons and switches and stuff because there wouldn't have been any chrome on there. So a little bit of work left. As I go along, we will come back for one more update before the final. Oh no, look, it's Godzilla! Yeah, I'm starting on that part of the diorama. While I'm waiting for paint to dry on the final pieces of the kit, I've got the chassis all set up with its exhaust. The engine is installed. It looks awesome. That is just the coolest thing ever. That thing really goes together nice. I've got the Canon dry brushed with some metallics. That's going to look sweet mounted in the back of the chassis. Look at that. That's going to look awesome. Got the headlights in, waiting for the clear part cement to dry. Got the tools on. Got the little lights with their clear Tamiya colors in them. Got our handles on, got our dashboard painted up. Can we even see it? No, it's kind of dark. Let's see if we can get a light over here. Ooh, there we go. Check that out. Painted them black and then used a silver pencil for the highlights and the script on the three badges over here. Just real faint detail, but you can see inside the cab. It looks great. Got the hood on. The hood will open and close, but I had it on so I could line up the grill. All I have to do now is just put a little yellow once the silver paint dries, and we'll be all set to go on the body. Got our steering wheel done. So everything is ready. We got the seats painted up. Those look sweet. We got their metal backs with their fabric fronts. We're ready to go. I've got the glass in the windshield. The windshield will still go up and down. That looks lovely. Now I am working on the Godzilla diorama before the final. He looks awesome so far. Everything just snaps free from its cardboard printout, and then you just press tab A into slot B exactly where it says on the directions. The directions are super easy to follow. No problems at all. All I have to do now is build the large power pole to sit over here and add more expansive to the diorama, and I just have to glue the rest of the body together. So, when we come back, we'll have Gojira, we'll have the Jeep done with the cannon on it, and it'll be all ready to go. I'll see you guys soon. MPC's 125th scale Army Jeep in the Godzilla diorama is done. Everything you see here is included in the box and more. Remember, if you build the military version or if you build the Suri version, you still end up with an extra grill, extra lights, extra top. You know, end up with a lot of cool stuff left over. The chrome hubs, all those chrome parts are going to be left in the box if you build the military version. Now, I absolutely love this little Jeep. And I'm really bummed out that I never bought this before. I've seen it released numerous times, and with the Godzilla package, just adds the extra level of awesomeness. The kit goes together beautifully, you saw it. There's no fit issues, there's no parts problems. That cannon looks absolutely awesome. The Jeep itself looks perfectly scale and just like the real world thing. We've got the decals on it that would have been in the Hong Kong movies with Godzilla and this awesome diorama. Now, anyone can build the diorama. It's just folding cardboard per the instructions. It's not like origami where it's going to drive you nuts. It's just tab A into slot B. You just push things in and they go right into place, and you have this awesome 3D diorama. I'm going to try to get this outside, see if I can get any normal pics, but I put a black background behind it here so that you can see how it looks with everything there. We'll get some better pics of the Jeep for you as well, but highly recommend this kit. You can pick this up from the folks at Round 2 and Model Roundup, your favorite hobby retailer, are all available. I will put a link in the description for you to get yours easiest, and just take a look. Everything is inside that box. The awesome Godzilla for the 61st anniversary, the Jeep with the Suri or the military options. Of course, I had to go military, and it looks phenomenal that way. We've got that whole diorama back there for the Godzilla fans. There's absolutely not one reason I can think of not to buy this kit. Thanks for watching this review, and we will see you at the next video.